Let's talk about searching a list. You can search a list to find information quickly, and there are different ways to help you get to the information you need. You can always apply sorting, so the data is presented in the order that you desire. You can apply grouping on the list, so you can see the data in groups, or you can simply search for a specific value on the list. There are two main ways to search within a list: the column search and the list search. You can simply search for what you want in the search box on the list title bar by selecting one of the predefined options in the dropdown. The list search allows you to quickly select an option and search for them specifically. The column search sorts the list based on a chosen field and returns records where the field's value exactly matches or starts with your search term. You can find a search box under each column title where you can have them displayed or hidden by simply clicking on this magnifying glass. For example, if I search for the keyword email, I'm presented with a list of records that start with the keyword email. Since there is no exact match for the short description email, I get no other results for that criteria. The list search allows you to select a particular field from the dropdown and search for values in that field, or alternatively, select for text and search for the keywords through all available fields in the list, and that returns any record that contains that value. Please note that the search function doesn't work on related lists. When you're searching for a value, it returns all records that are either equal or greater than that value. As an example, if I select for the color Ali, it will only return the records where the color starts with that keyword. However, if I select color from the dropdown on the list search and search for the same keyword, two things will happen. First, it's sorted in an ascending order based on the column that I've selected, which in this case is color. Second, not only I get the results that matches my search criteria, but I also get all values that are greater than that. In this example, I see all records where the color names are greater than the search term that I entered. If I search for another name like David, I can see all incidents where the color's name starts with David, or the names start with a value that is greater than David. When you're searching on the choice list fields, you have the option to search for either the label of the field or the value of the field. For example, new on the state column is only a label. However, the value of it in the dictionary is set as 1. Let's do another search, this time on states. I'll select state from the dropdown on the list search. I know that the resolved state has a value of 6 in the dictionary. So if I search for 6, I'm presented with the results that are either in the resolved state or in the closed state, since closed comes after resolved in the dictionary. You can get the most out of your searches with the power of wildcards. Wildcards allow you to match variations and patterns in your search terms, expanding your results beyond exact matches. You can use wildcard characters in your global text search, knowledge bases, searchable lists, and reference fields. ServiceNow supports several wildcard characters to expand and refine your search results. Here are the available list search wildcards. You can use an asterisk with a search term to search for values that contain that search term. If you start with a percent sign and your search term next, you're basically searching for values that end with that search term. You can start with an equal sign and then your search term, and that searches for values that equal search term. And that is the exact match for that particular search term. You can also use the exclamation mark to provide the opposite results. For example, starting with an exclamation mark and then an asterisk with a search term allows you to search for values that don't contain that search term. Starting with an exclamation mark and then the equal sign with your search term searches for values that don't equal that particular search term. Let's start testing the wildcard characters. Let me search for the keyword email in the short description with the asterisk wildcard. I can see the list of all incidents where the short description contains the word email. This includes those incidents that also start with the keyword email. If I change that to percent sign and search it again, I can see the list of all incidents that the short description ends with the keyword email. This time, let's try the exclamation mark with the asterisk and search for the keyword email. This lists all incidents where the short description does not contain email. Now let's try the equal sign wildcard. Let's search for reset my password. I can see there are two incidents where the short description is an exact match to my search term. If I use the exclamation mark in the beginning of my search, this should return all incidents where the short description is not reset my password. Please note that there is a difference between the column search we're doing and the list search that sits on the top of the form on the title bar. I'm going to search on the number column. If I search for all incidents that contain the number 90, I get a few results. However, if I use the percent sign in the beginning and then the number 90, I can only see one match, and that's the incident where the number ends with the number 90. When I'm using the list search, I would see a different behavior. Let's try number from the list and search for the number 90. Interestingly, I get the same result since the list search returns all incidents where the number ends with 90. I can use wildcards in the list search when I'm searching for a text, and that means I'm searching for all keywords in the ticket, not only the short description. For the keyword phone, with a percent sign in the beginning, I can only see one match, and that's the incident where the keyword iPhone is listed in the short description. Now, let me change my wildcard to the asterisk. I'm presented with a list of all incidents where the keyword phone is listed there. So I can see iPhone, my desk phone, headphone, and probably incidents where the keyword phone is somehow being used in the ticket. In this example, I can see the keyword phone in the description of this incident. I probably can see the same result, not necessarily in the short description, but in the other fields of the incident. Now I want to use multiple wildcards in my search term. Let's try to mix them. This time I'm going to use the percent sign, the letter M, asterisk, the letter L. Let's see what results we get. In my search results, I can see email, but at the same time, I can see employee. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. See you soon!